Let us pray. Almighty God, as we gather together today, I'm reminded that you have granted us the privilege of living in the greatest nation on earth, and that you have given us blessings beyond measure, freedom of worship, freedom to study the Bible, freedom to vote, freedom to get an education. God, we thank you for all of these freedoms. We know that they come to us because your Son Jesus Christ suffered and died on the cross for our sins. We are unworthy. We confess our sins. God, we thank you for government. And Lord, we know that the government that we have, that it's going to fail. We know that the devil has always tried to corrupt our government, and tried to establish a government like he wants, and not the government that you want. God, we know that your word says that the day will come when the government will be upon the shoulders of your Son, Jesus Christ. And there will be peace and righteousness and justice on earth. Poverty will be done away with. Sickness will be done away with. That we will be blessed. There will be no more war. There will be peace. We look forward to that government that you are going to set up. But in the meantime, God, you have given us another kind of government. And you put over us men of your own choosing. And God, some it seems like they listen to you, and some it seems like they don't. God, we're not worthy of a good government. Sometimes I think that you give us the kind of government that we deserve, and we don't deserve a good government. But God, we ask that you would not look at our sins, for our sins are many. Not look at the sins of the society that we live in, because our society is corrupt. But that you would look up on your Son Jesus Christ as he was dying upon that cross, and that you would remember your grace and your mercy and your love, and that you would look upon the United States of America with grace, with forgiveness, with mercy, with love. We thank you for our president. Your word tells us that we should pray for him. We pray for him. We know that he has many great burdens upon his shoulders. We know, Lord, that he's surrounded by many people, some who give him good advice and some who give him bad advice. We pray, Lord, that he will take the advice of the Holy Spirit, that you would be his counselor and that you would guide him. And, Lord, that he would know your will from the will of others and that he would do your will. We pray that you would keep him healthy, that you would make him a great president, that you would make him a great leader. He's commanding our soldiers, Lord, and some of them are dying on foreign fields. Their safety is in his hands. Lord, we ask you to help him. We ask you to make him a strong commander, that you'll make him a great leader. Lord, we thank you for some of the decisions that have been made lately. And Lord, we just pray that more decisions that are according to your will be made in the future. Help him to stand up. Surround him with people who are called by you, people who will listen to you, people who will give him good advice, people who will be led by the Holy Spirit. God, we pray for our state leaders and our local leaders, our city leaders. We pray for your wisdom to permeate all the way down from the top, from your throne through the president to the states, to the state legislators, and to the city governments. God, help our leaders. God, we thank you for our judges. Lord, it seems like some of the decisions that have been made lately are good and some are bad. We thank you for the decision to stop partial birth abortion. Lord, we pray for other decisions like this, decisions that will be in accordance with your will and your word. Help these judges not to look to the laws of the European Union or other countries or the United Nations, but to look to your law as written in your word, for it's going to abide forever, and this is what you want us to go by. Give us wise judges, God-fearing judges. Give us laws that are according to your word and not according to man's word. We ask you to forgive us of our sins, to have mercy upon us. And God, we pray these things because we love you, because we love your Son, Jesus Christ, because we're the most blessed people on earth. And it is right that we pray for these leaders. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.